The people that walked in darkness have seen a great light. On those who live in a land of deep shadow, a light has shone. For there is a child born for us, a son given to us, and dominion is laid on his shoulders. And this is the name they give him: Wondrous Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. Wide is his dominion, in a peace that has no end, for the throne of David and for his royal power, which he establishes and makes secure in justice and integrity. From this time onwards and forever, the jealous love of God will do this. The word of the Lord.
Yeah. the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, and the virgin's name was Mary. He went in and said to her, "Rejoice, so highly favoured, the Lord is with you." She was deeply disturbed by these words and asked herself, "What is this greeting? What this greeting could mean?" But the angel said to her, "Mary, do not be afraid. You have won God's favour. Listen, you are to conceive and bear a son, and you must name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High. The Lord will give him the throne of his ancestor David. He will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his reign will have no end." Mary said to the angel, But how can this come about, since I am a virgin?" "The Holy Spirit will come upon you," the angel answered, "and the power of the Most High will cover you with its shadow. And so the child will be holy and will be called the Son of God. I am the handmaid of the Lord," said Mary. "Let what you have said be done to me." And the angel left her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Caesar Augustus issued a decree for a census of the whole world to be taken. This census took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to be registered. So Joseph set forth from the town of Nazareth in Galilee and travelled up to Judea, to the town of David called Bethlehem, since he was of David's house and line, in order to be registered together with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to a son, her firstborn. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room at the inn. The Gospel of the Lord.
In the countryside, close by, there were shepherds who lived in the fields and took it in turn to watch their flocks during the night. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified, but the angel said, "Do not be afraid. Listen, I bring you great news of joy, a joy to be shared by the whole people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. And here is a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, with the angel, there was a great throng of heavenly hosts, praising God and singing, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace to those who enjoy his favor." Now when the angel had gone from the highest heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see the thing that had happened, which the Lord hath made known to us." So they hurried away. They found Mary and Joseph, and a baby lying in a manger. When they saw the child, they repeated what they had been told about him. And everyone who heard it was astonished at what the shepherds had to say. As for Mary, she treasured all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds went back, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was exactly as they had been told. The Gospel of the Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things came to be. Not one thing had its being, but through him. All that came to be had life in him, and that life was the light of man, a light that shines in the dark, a light that darkness could never overpower. The Word was the true light that enlightens all men, and he was coming into the world. He was in the world that had its being through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own home, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To all who believe in the name of him, who was not born not of human stock, or blood of flesh or will of man, but of God himself. The Word was made flesh, he lived among us, and we saw his glory, the glory that is his as the only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Thank you. Yeah.